Don't let it worry you, Skipper. I'm just a crazy, darn fool duck.
First premiering in April 17th, 1937, Daffy Duck became a staple in households everywhere with his quirky voice and zany behavior. And though it was funny, fans felt that he was also completely unhinged, which caused them to wonder if he had any kind of mental disorders because of his actions, something I never even thought of. But if it's one thing I love, it's psychology. So while those things are definitely contenders, if he had to have one, I would definitely say that it's antisocial personality disorder. And there is no other show that this is most apparent in than the Looney Tunes Show. This show takes the Looney Tunes characters and reimagines them into what they will be like in the real world. You have Speedy Gonzalez owning a pizzeria, Porky Pig being an accountant, and Bugs is just, well, he's just rich. While Daffy just lives off of Bugs.
Squidward is not a freeloader, and he would never take advantage of me.
Many months later.
I know he still isn't looking for work! Don't rub it in!
Now, it would be a different story if he wasn't doing so good in life and he needed some help, right? But no, he intentionally lives off of Bugs and takes advantage of his kindness without showing any regard to how he might feel. There are several people he does this to, like Speedy,
it's root beer.
His girlfriend Tina.
What is wrong with you?
And Porky. Poor Porky.
The butter is hard.
I'm sorry. I just got so busy with the creme brulee.
But you're not too busy to make excuses.
He has an almost otherworldly disinterest in normal social behavior and right or wrong. We see this further by how often he likes to lie in order to get what he wants.
In all the time, I say all the time I've known you, I had no idea you were a child.
Well, I've always felt I was wise beyond my years.
Everyone in the show will be the first to tell you that this guy likes to lie a lot. He'll lie about his occupation, his own age, and even changed his name to Professor, finessed his way into teaching a class about political science, and made a game out of failing students. He thinks it's fun, and in his mind, he's just playing a role.
Make up an excuse. Lie. I'm not gonna lie. That's your area. Good point. Know your role.
Which leads me to my second point, being how he never learns from his mistakes. Like when he completely ruined Foghorn Leghorn's movie, who, mind you, is a CEO of a successful company, with not only his terrible acting, but also his weird inability to take accountability for anything. And then after costing the CEO thousands of dollars, he manages to one-up that by doing the unthinkable.
That one there was a violation.
This guy is a menace to society. Though he's completely aware of what he does and the effects he has on other people, he still does these things over and over again. Not even military school could do anything to him. And that only scratches the surface for what he does next. Now, I'm not sure if this is illegal or not, but who does that, bro? Anyways, almost everything this duck does is some sort of crime. Randomly punching two strangers? Aggravated battery. Impersonating someone else at a country club and using their money? Identity theft. And many, many more, man. The lying, disregard for right or wrong, criminal antics, and just crazy bursts of aggression are all telltale symptoms for this extraordinary yet complex disorder. If you know anyone who is like this duck here, proceed with caution or get out of there because all your money will be gone in a snap. But hey, I'm not a psychologist, so whatever. Daffy Duck is one of my favorite Looney Tunes characters because he's this way, to be honest. Call me crazy, but I love this toxic dude. Who are y'all's favorite Looney Tunes characters? And was I on the money with this, or was I completely off? Let me know because I'd love to hear y'all's make-believe diagnoses if y'all have any. Until then, I'll catch you all in the next one. Peace out.